So in case you haven't been paying attention, yesterday evening, Donald Trump was released from Walter Reed Medical Center, flown by the helicopter back to the White House. He walked up the steps, immediately took off his mask, because that's exactly what we want COVID positive people to do. Gave some poses because they were compiling a propaganda ad, which was released shortly thereafter. And he also gave an address, a very brief address, because as we could see from all the video footage, he was struggling to breathe. Every time the man inhaled, you could see in his eyes that it was hurting him. But nevertheless, he gave an address and said, hey, don't let fear rule your life. Don't be afraid of COVID, a similar sentiment as to what he had said on Twitter not long before that. So he is out there right now telling Americans, don't be afraid of this. Don't worry about it. I mean, look, I beat it in like 3 days. First of all, you didn't beat it. Let's get that out of the way right now. You haven't beat it. You're not out of the woods yet. You haven't even hit the most dangerous part of the infection yet. And if you do pull through, it's because of government-funded healthcare that kept you alive throughout it. You know, the rest of us, we don't have access to private helicopters. We don't have access to a full team of doctors who have nothing else to do other than pay attention to us for 24 straight hours. We don't have access to experimental drugs. We don't have to worry, or we do have to worry, unlike you, about paying massive hospital bills. So there's a big difference. We don't have the same worries as you. So maybe you don't have to worry about COVID. The rest of us do. And your message is absolutely going to get people killed. That image of you almost ripping off that face mask, that sends a message to people that you don't need this thing. You brought that virus back into a White House that's already been ravaged by it. I think the last count was you have at least 17 White House staffers who have tested positive, possibly 19. And you're sitting there, or walking there, really, bringing it back in with you. So the question I have is, what happens to somebody like Trump, who's trying to get over the virus, when they are constantly being exposed to other people who have the virus? So they're still getting viral loads into their body as their body's trying to fight off what's already inside and replicating. It's going to be a lot harder to do when you have the introduction of new viruses into the human body on a near constant basis by going back to the White House. But we know why he did this. And it's reflected in the memes and talking points of the crazy people on the right. The Keep America Great 2020 Facebook group actually released a photograph last night, photoshopped x-ray of Donald Trump, allegedly, that also had the Superman S on it. Matt Gaetz said, Trump's not going to have to recover from COVID. COVID's going to have to recover from Trump. They look at this man as if he is truly a godlike character, a superhero. Why? This geriatric, obese individual who's a total fraud, who doesn't have anywhere near the success that he wants people to think he has. The only thing he's good at is convincing stupid people that he is the ideal male form in both body and personality. That's nuts. But not as nuts as what he did yesterday. Let's be real for just a moment. If you watch those videos, if you watch Donald Trump standing outside on that veranda, here's what you saw him do. He can't breathe. The president can't breathe. And he hasn't even hit the bad part of this yet. He left the hospital early, I guarantee you, against the wishes of medical professionals. And medical professionals who spoke to other media outlets yesterday all said the same thing that I have been saying since he went to the hospital. And that is, you don't really get like hit with this till after about a week and a half to 2 weeks. That's when the problem period begins. And not only because of the virus, but because that's when your immune system shoots into overdrive. and essentially overreacts to the virus. And that is what has caused, or what has caused, excuse me, a lot of damage in individuals who have survived this. It has also caused a lot of damage and caused people to not survive this. Donald Trump is nowhere near out of the woods. He's barely even into the woods at this point. So what happens next? What happens when he has the relapse? What happens when he hits that danger point and the virus comes back and it's resistant to the remdesivir and all the other experimental drugs they've treated him with because they gave them to him too soon? What then? What are they going to treat him with at that point? How's that going to look to his followers? Are they still going to think that he's a Superman? Are they still going to think that the whole thing's a hoax? Time will tell. But what he did yesterday was incredibly irresponsible and dangerous. And eventually, based on what we've seen so far with what's happening inside the White House, very likely to get somebody killed.